Hey, Scott Maple here from Crop Circle. I just wanted to show you a project that I've been working on this past week, which is rather unique. And I was approached by a director friend of mine who was asking for a prop to be made. They were looking to simulate a scene similar to Aliens, where the characters put their hand on a table and the android stabs between the fingers at rapid speed with the knife, never once hitting the side of the finger. In this case, this film actually calls for a pencil to be doing the same thing. So the actor is supposed to be stabbing into a desk with their fingers spread. And obviously they were rather concerned that the actor might be injured when they're plunging down with a real pencil between their fingers. So I was asked if I could make a rubber pencil. And that's what I've done here. But the project took me on a unique journey into some new materials. And with the help of Ian from Sculpture Supply Canada, I was able to source the materials that worked out incredibly well for this project, thankfully with no failures along the way, despite how many new paths needed to be taken. And I just wanted to share that experience with you because these are the pencils that were done, the copy pencils, and these are the originals over here. So originally a very small thin mold was used, silicone mold, into which I required to inject material in a tube. So this tube was the stabilizing factor for a very floppy, otherwise silicone mold. And I was shown a material, Task 16, which had properties, which I broke here. I wanted to see if the pencil would sever at this width, because it's a very small and thin instrument, but we needed the rigidity that it would be straight, not too floppy, but yet firm enough that it would not also puncture a person or pose any threat to them when they were stabbing down. A couple of the pieces that I did ended up being rather too soft, and I was concerned that even though this is going to be in their hands, that it might look too floppy. So in the last four that were done, I used a coffee stirrer and managed to feed it up into the base of the silicone mold so that when the material cured in there, it would be stable up to a certain point before the pencil would have to be bent. And you wouldn't be seeing that on camera anyway. Now, the aspect of this that was so unique and new to me, I was shown a most innovative material that I plan to use in a lot of future projects. And I'm not sure if you've ever heard of this. It's called FlexiPaint, and it's from a company called FlexiPaint in the UK, flexipaint.co.uk. And this is a clear one, and they're all gloss at this point, but they can be mixed with water. They're totally non-toxic. And I was amazed at using this material at just how good it was in getting paint, even water-thinned paint, to stick to a polyurethane rubber surface. It's incredible. I can't believe it. I can bend this, it won't crack. And what was required, the instructions actually called for mixing the material with up to 30% pigment for it to be effective and still maintain its properties. And I found that even with thinned with water, the ratio of five parts flexi paint to one part water thinned it enough that I could actually get the paint onto the surface here. And the objective was that eventually I was going to dry brush in the letters, because they were that was going to be a lot of hand painting. In the end, this part is going to be concealed by the actor in their hands, so I just drew in the detail with a fine tip pen on the end. But my point being is that it took a few layers of very thin paint. I was concerned that the paint was going to be, or the flexi paint was going to be too thick and fill in the lettering on the pencils by just the amount of body in the acrylic. So it was thinned out with water. It took a few coats to actually get it to stick, but if you persevere and it dries in about 10 minutes time, you just go on with many, many thin layers. I believe I went with three layers before I actually got to being able to use just straight acrylic on top of this. That was the most amazing part, is that after the first layers of the flexi paint took, I was able to go in with pure acrylic to obtain the correct cerulean blue finish. I just love saying cerulean blue. That the pencil manufacturer had here. So in creating that, that's how it ended up working out. And I'm very pleased with how these have turned out, the stable ones. They actually will look quite realistic in the hand. And just using various tints in the Flexi Paint over all of the surfaces, I was able to simulate everything with just acrylic paints mixed into it. But amazing product, this Flexi Paint. And on top of Task 16, it is going to be my new additive. And I've really always shied away from trying to paint flexible surfaces, particularly the ones that needed some durability. But I am very impressed, folks. Good job. Try it out. You're going to love it. And thank you, Sculpture Supply Canada and Ian. Scott Maple from Crop Circle, signing off.